Who would have thought we'd experience that again? A cutting-edge two-stroke engine developed right in the heart of Detroit, the historic motor city in the USA. While most manufacturers have long since shifted to traditional four-stroke engines or even electric mobility, the startup Alpha-Otto is introducing a new technology to the market with the REV Force, which was nearly considered extinct. Two-stroke engines were practically written off for years due to strict emission laws and high fuel consumption, and now this, a new engine that aims to completely redefine the game. But what's really behind it, and could the REV Force potentially become the future of motorcycle propulsion?
The good, the bad, and the ugly.
For many in the motorcycle community, two-strokes are legendary. Lightweight, rev-happy, simple in design, and with an unmistakable sound. In the 80s and 90s, they were a common sight on the streets. Models like the RD or the Aprilia RS250 are cult today. But stricter emissions regulations and a bad rep for smoke and noise brought it to an end. By the 2000s at the latest, the two-stroke engine almost completely disappeared from mass production. The reason? They were deemed too dirty, too inefficient, and no longer in line with modern standards. The comeback looked unlikely, until now. Alpha-Otto is completely revamping the topic from the ground up. The REV Force isn't a throwback to old technology, it's an entirely newly developed liquid-cooled pure two-cylinder two-stroke with compressor supercharging, direct injection and rotary exhaust control. The most important aspect is that the piston is no longer responsible for drawing in the mixture. A separate system now handles the control of airflow, compression, mixture formation and cylinder filling. This allows the engine to be tuned for maximum power or extreme efficiency, depending on the need. This flexibility stands as the key difference when compared to classic two-strokes and even most four-strokes. But how can a two-stroke engine suddenly become clean and efficient? That's precisely what we're going to examine right now. The heart of the REV Force is the complete control over the combustion process. Compressor, direct injection, and a sophisticated engine management system ensure that the engine always receives the optimal mixture, whether running on gasoline, diesel, natural gas, ethanol, or even hydrogen. The engine control system automatically detects the fuel and adjusts the parameters in real time. This allows the REV Force to run on virtually any type of fuel, making it highly future-proof and nearly independent of specific fuel sources available. What's truly fascinating is that the engine sounds entirely different depending on the fuel it's using. In addition, the precise control significantly reduces emissions. In combination with regenerative fuels, an almost CO2 neutral operation is even possible. The developers state a thermal efficiency of over 50%, a value that is hardly achieved by any modern combustion engine otherwise. Modern gasoline engines typically achieve 20 to 35%, and even the best diesel engines barely reach 50%, are possible here. Values that are otherwise more commonly associated with fuel cells or turbines can be achieved. A clean two-stroke with 170 horsepower sounds too good to be true, but the performance figures speak for themselves. The REV Force delivers an impressive 173 horsepower, or 127 kilowatts, with just 48 kilograms of weight. This puts it not only at the top in terms of power, but also in power-to-weight ratio. A dream value especially for motorcycles, but also in other areas like lightweight vehicles, boats, aircraft, or compact generators, for example the power cube concept, the engine can be utilized. Thanks to its compact design and high fuel flexibility, it could be deployed anywhere where power, efficiency, and space-saving solutions are essential and highly valued. Another highlight mentioned by the developers is a generous inspection interval of 2,000 operating hours, a clear advantage compared to many highly tuned four-strokes. The straightforward design, lacking a camshaft and intricate valve train, not only cuts down on maintenance costs, but also reduces potential points of failure. Still, many questions remain. Will the REV Force truly impress in the demanding world of motorcycles? Keyword: everyday life. What about emissions and political hurdles? Is the engine genuinely sustainable for the future? According to Alpha-Otto, the REV Force's emission levels are reported to be up to 30% lower than those of current engines. With hydrogen operation, nearly emission-free operation is even possible. This is particularly exciting in light of increasingly stringent emissions regulations. While the much-debated ban on combustion engines for cars in Europe never applied to motorcycles, the regulations in this area are also becoming stricter. At the same time, skepticism towards purely electric drives persists within the scene. Insufficient range, excessive weight, lack of emotion, and let's not even get started on the missing infrastructure. Could the REV Force actually halt the decline of combustion engines? It's possible, but only if the technology truly delivers on its promises. Alpha-Otto's partners with established manufacturers for the market launch, steering clear of in-house production. Initial prototypes are reported to have already been constructed and successfully tested with a range of fuels, including hydrogen as well. The engines are internationally patented, and the company is already in contact with major players in the industry. Currently, a funding round is also in progress, with Alpha-Otto aiming to reach full production readiness and drive the market launch forward. For those interested, all the details can be found on the company's website. Still, it remains uncertain whether the REV Force will succeed in the motorcycle market. The scene is tense, as the potential for a comeback of the two-stroke engine is undoubtedly present and real. The REV Force by Alpha-Otto is undoubtedly one of the most exciting engine developments of recent years. High-tech meets two-stroke charm, efficiency meets power, and perhaps we might genuinely witness the two-stroke engine's triumphant return to the road. But the crucial question is, what do you think? Will the engine really make it to production, and can it deliver on its promises?